trying a new layout with my videos. I don't know if I'm gonna keep it, cause, you know, too lazy to stand up all the time. And, you know, I don't really know what video I was watching, but after the video, I saw a link for a video called The True Story of Kurt Cobain's Death, or something along those lines. So, I watched this video, and it looks like there's either, like, I don't know how old these kids are. One looks like maybe he's 10, and the other looks maybe 8. And the kid has a fucking guitar, and he's just, like, playing two notes that only one's actually from Smell Like Teen Spirit. At least you got one note right, kid. And then, like, he doesn't look like Kurt at all. All he has is, like, this little wig that doesn't look shit like Kurt's hair. That's Kurt's hair. Nice try, Skippy. And then the door rings. I mean, fucking, doorbell rings. So Kurt walks down the stairs, answers, and there's this kid with his hat, like a gangster hat, like acting like one of Kurt's fans. Do you know what kind of music Kurt played, little kid? Gangsters don't like grunge. I mean, you failed bad at Kurt. You could have at least done something about the band. But anyway, he goes on like, I'm a big fan, can you sign this? Can you sign this? Kurt would have been like, the fuck out of my house. But no, he signed it, walked away, the doorbell rang. Normally, if it was really Kurt, he probably wouldn't have answered the door again. But now he goes down, opens the door, and there's the kid again. And he just jumps around like a fucking kid on crack. So he closes the door. And then the third time, the kid, like, this keeps going on and on. And finally, the kid asks for his hair. He tells him to fuck off and closes the door. And this is where shit starts getting extremely stupid. So Kurt goes back to his room, gets his guitar, plays two notes and says, come as you are, come as you are, yeah, come as you... I'm like, dude, learn the fucking lyrics if you can even try to sing the song. Jesus fucking Christ. And then the kid breaks his window and goes in. My question is, if Kurt was so rich, why was there no alarm? So then he runs over, like the kid's there with a knife, and the knife is to cut his hair. Why not a pair of scissors? That kid didn't have the knife when he walked in, so if you're going around the house looking for something to cut hair with, you can use a knife or scissors. Anyway. So he goes in, they start chasing each other around. Kurt, like, throws the kid against the wall and he drops a knife. Kurt tries to call 911 and the kid throws a knife at him. And then Kurt falls down the doorway. And then the kid pulls out like this, doesn't even look like a shotgun, but he's like, give me your hair or I'll kill you. So he's like, I won't give you my hair, so he shoots him. Then he puts the gun on his chest, steals his hair, and runs away. So, let me get this straight, kiddies. You're making fun of the tragic death of a bipolar artist who killed himself. And through that suicide, caused about, well, I can't even count how many copycat suicides there were. I've heard a lot of different statistics. All I know is it's over 20. And that's a lot for a single suicide to take out that many kids, including a kindergartner who blew his fucking head off because Kurt did. Really funny, kids. And so, you know what? Before you start really pissing people off, how about you just go back and listen to the fucking Jonas Brothers like you know you love to? And I swear, I don't care how young you are, if I ever saw you doing that shit around me, kick your ass. No, I'm threatening to beat up a bunch of little kids. I don't care. I'm not a nice person. I never claim to be a nice person. Especially when you insult my fucking hero. So,